Hello everyone, this is Arthur from Art Studio Lab and welcome back to my another video tutorial. And this time we're going to have some fun in Adobe Photoshop to create a double exposure effect, which is originally used with two or more separate photos to blend and merge them into one surreal image. You've probably seen this effect in some digital artists, TV shows, album covers, magazines, or advertisements. The common subjects of this effect that are often combined are portraits or profile and the scenes of nature. In this tutorial, we will use the Photoshop's blending modes and clipping masks to create this trendy and amazing effect. So begin by opening your chosen image in Photoshop. Ideally, the background of the image will have a nice clean solid color or white color without noisy elements such as trees or foliage to make it easier to work with. You can download the images that I'm using here in the description area, or you can find your own quality images on the web. Now we need to separate the subject from the background. I'm using the select and mask method in order to select the subject. But for those who are using the older version of Photoshop, you can use quick selection method or any method of selection you want as long as the selection of the subject is nice and good. Activate the marquee tool. And on the top options bar, click select and mask. In order to see the subject that you are masking, choose one of the view modes in the properties panel. I'm choosing the red overlay mode. Begin painting over the subject with an appropriate brush size. The Photoshop will try to stuff wherever it reaches an edge. It does a pretty good selection in most places, but sometimes you have to press and hold the Alt or Option key to paint back in some parts of the mask. Once you've painted overall the subject, choose the refine edge brush to perfect areas like hair or fur. Paint in those areas to capture the fine strands. Play around with sliders to get the fine tune of the selection. Click OK to make the selection, then press the Ctrl or Command and J to make it in a new layer. Select the background layer and press the Alt and Backspace shortcut to fill the background with white. Now, select the image and desaturate it. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Desaturate to transform the image to black and white. Find your landscape image and import it in your Photoshop document. Then move it to the top of the layer stack. Reduce the opacity of the landscape image for you to see where you can replace it around the portrait. Then press the Ctrl or Command and T to scale the image independently to find the best composition. And after that, change back the opacity to 100%. Press and hold the Ctrl or Command key and click on the thumbnail of the portrait layer to load its selection. Then click on the layer mask icon of the landscape layer to form a big silhouette of the portrait. Make the copy of the portrait layer. So select it and press the Ctrl or Command and J to duplicate it and move it on the top of the layer stack. Then change the blending mode to lighten. Now, reduce the opacity of it around 50%. Apply a layer mask on this layer, then set the large soft brush with black fill. Change the flow to around 30% on the top options bar and paint around the edges of the portrait to erase anything except the facial features. Select the layer mask of the landscape layer, then begin painting on the facial area of the portrait so the features are still visible through the landscape. Grab the eyedropper from the tools menu, then sample the color from the image. Select the background layer and press the Alt and Backspace shortcut to fill it with this color. Select the landscape layer and press the Ctrl, Command, and J to duplicate it. Then delete the layer mask on it. And change the blending mode to lighten. Hold Alt or Option key and click on the layer mask icon to add a layer mask. Then grab the brush tool with white fill. Then paint on the clouds area to make only this part visible. Finish off the double exposure by applying some cool effects. Press Alt, Control, Shift, and E to make the stamp visible layer. Then go to Image, Adjustments, and Desaturate to make it black and white. And after that, select the blending mode to soft light. Adjust the opacity to 75%. Next is choose the color lookup adjustment layer. And on the settings, choose the foggy night LUT preset. Adjust the opacity to around 50%. The final result is a cool blend between two images to create a surreal piece of image, which is perfect for posters or album covers. The big advantage of doing this in Photoshop is you can experiment with different images to find the best mix. So, if you enjoyed this tutorial or learned anything new, be sure to give a like and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to ring the bell so you can see more of my upcoming video tips and tutorials. So thank you so much for watching, and see you on the next one.